Summer is supposed to be fun, right?
Yes, I totally agree. Summer of fun.
It's time for Frozen auditions, and Nene meets someone pretty important. It's time to find out what happened in Season 3, Episode 2 of High School Musical, the musical, the series. What's up, Wildcats? Lisa here, and it's time to talk about another episode of High School Musical, the series, the longest title ever, which they actually make fun of in this episode. This time, we're up to Season 3, Episode 2, titled Into the Unknown, which is fitting since it focuses on the auditions for Frozen, and our characters kind of waiting on the unknown. What role are they going to get? Or Nene's case, what the future holds. Now, I think I say this every video, but I am loving the music on this show. I swear it gets better every season. And one thing I love is the mashups that they do. We get the audition scene in this episode. I'm a sucker for a good audition scene in TV and movies anyway, but the Frozen songs, the way they mashed them up, so good. And the original songs. We get one from Sophia Wiley and Olivia Rodrigo this episode, and both are great. One's obviously the more fast-paced, and one's kind of the more acoustic guitar song, but I don't know. It's so good. I feel like the performance they put out of It's On to tease this season was actually one of the weaker performances, even though I love the camp rock songs, and that's kind of what they were going for, was to say, oh, we're doing these too. Also, Adrian Lyles, we finally get to hear him sing. He plays Jet. That boy can sing. Okay, so this episode builds up some of the love drama with EJ and Gina, and then they're of course throwing Ricky in the mix now that he is back in camp, and we also have Val, played by Meg Donnelly, coming in, and she kind of forms another, you know, I guess side of the square, even though she's not kind of in on it. It's more of like Gina thinking that she's a threat somehow, but let's just dive into this episode. Alright, so first we're going to talk about Nene's storyline. She's kind of basically all off on her own. She's now in California with her moms, and Nene's about to turn 18. She's thinking of growing up. Her moms are thinking she's growing up. So they've decided it's time for Nene to re-meet their old friend Marvin. Now why, you may ask? Well, it turns out he's the sperm donor, aka technically Nene's father. So Marvin, played by Jesse Tyler Ferguson, comes over, and well, it's pretty awkward at first between him and Nene. They don't have much in common, until it happens to come up that Marvin and the moms used to be in a band together way back when. Now, Nene and Marvin are able to bond over music and stuff, and Marvin gives some great parting advice to help Nene, which seems to get her out of her writer's block.
I remember what it was like to be your age. Everything seemed unpredictable, but I promise you, Nene, the best is yet to come.
Yeah, that advice ends up inspiring her to write and perform the song You Never Know. Now we'll just have to wait and see what is next for Nene, especially since we know this is Olivia Rodrigo's last season. She's only technically a special guest star in the season, so she's not in every episode. So we'll have to see if she does end up making it to camp, maybe for a last goodbye, because I feel like that needs to happen. If she's going to say goodbye to this show, she needs to also say goodbye to all her friends. Alright, now let's move over to Camp Shallow Lake. So EJ still hasn't told anyone but Gina that he is now the director of the musical, and he's super nervous about it. And yes, this is when the show really starts to make fun of itself and get meta. Yeah, they're going there.
EJ Caswell from Disney Plus is Frozen, the musical, the series.
They would never call the show that. It's way too long and complicated, the title.
Like, seriously, the title of this show is still way too long. I never know whether I should abbreviate it or type out the whole title when I title these videos. It's kind of annoying. Can we just, like, shorten it down to just, like, the High School Musical show or something? I don't know. I don't have power in that way. But moving on, we still have some awkwardness when it comes to Ricky showing up.
Can you believe Ricky showed up?
Oh, when are you going to tell everyone you're directing the show?
Yeah, you see that deflection from Gina? She is not ready to talk about it. As for Ricky, he awakens to Carlos on his bed, and Ricky, of course, does not want to talk about the Lily situation. Now, Carlos, he's really just focusing on auditions because basically all the campers think this is their big break. They're going to be on Disney Plus with this whole documentary, so they gotta get the best parts and they gotta be on their A-game. And well, Ricky, he's still not kind of taking it seriously, so Carlos tells Ricky he can't just Zephron his way through, so we'll see if Ricky actually takes his audition seriously this time. Oh, and Ricky also finally notices the mysterious Jet. Can I also just say, I think I did say this last episode too, Carlos and Courtney stealing every scene they're in. Like, Courtney asking the cameraman for his phone just makes me laugh.
Do either of you have a phone on you?
Can I just hold it? Just for a second.
I mean, I don't think I could survive 2 weeks without a phone, so I gotta give it up for Courtney for pushing on through. Okay. So now we all know that Gina really wants a lead role in this musical, especially since it's going to be broadcast in multiple countries. She is ready for it, and the girls kind of point out that some of Gina 1.0 is creeping back in, that competitiveness that Gina has, but you know, Gina's not seeing yet. We then get Gina's solo song and dance. It's a song called Balance. It is super catchy. There's some great dancing, some choreography. Sophia Wiley's killing it. And I mean, anytime someone spells a word in a song, it, like Gwen Stefani did with Bananas, it just gets stuck in my head. Okay, but let's get back to the real thing that people talk about, which is Rini and Portwell. We have Ricky and Gina running into each other on the way to breakfast, and let's just say it's pretty awkward. And Ricky's just awkward doing his, like, reverse thing. He should have talked backwards as well. But I guess there's something kind of endearing about Ricky here. But yeah, Ricky and Gina decide they're going to start over. Hopefully there's going to be no drama this summer because it's supposed to be fun, but we'll see how long that lasts. And now it's time to move on to auditions in the barn. EJ still hasn't told anybody that he is directing. He's trying to wait till this last minute. And we can see that everybody's excited thinking that they're going to see Corbin Blue. We then get to meet Val, played by Meg Donnelly, another counselor in training who will be choreographing the show and is friends with EJ. And it seems like we can see a spark of jealousy in Gina's eyes here. Because she's like, hey, who's that? And so Maddox says that there's history there. But I think it's just a friendship. They just want to show that Gina's kind of like questioning things. Now EJ tells Val what's going on, and she tells him to basically go out there and act like he knows what he's doing, and that she's also going to be the one to cast the musical alone, so there's no bias, which he's kind of sad about because that's the only thing he was excited for. Now as they prep for these auditions, Courtney goes to offer her services to Maddox, who awkwardly turns them down. You know, she says she doesn't need help with the makeup and hair and stuff, and we learn that Maddox basically has a hard time making friends. She doesn't know how to do it anymore. She was used to having this like whole crew that she hung out with, but they grew up and moved on from camp. So now she's just like, I don't know what to do. She thinks she doesn't need any help. She doesn't want to let anybody in. She's got this like wall up. She also mentions that there's one camper in particular she used to hang out with. Now, we have to wonder if that's where JoJo Siwa's character fits in, who we got a glimpse of in the trailer for the whole season. If you go back and watch that trailer, we can see that that character is pretty close to Maddox. So I wonder if that's what that is. Now, before auditions, Ricky goes back to the cabin to get a prop, which is like this super 80s kind of snowsuit thing, and he ends up running into Jet, who's still in the cabin, and we learn that Jet used to sing but doesn't anymore, and so we have to wonder why. Right before auditions, we see Gina 1.0 kind of give these two young campers advice that might not be so good. She basically says that those two should no longer be friends but competition. Thankfully, later during the audition, we kind of see this look that Gina may realize that maybe she didn't give such good advice, and that maybe Gina 1.0 is coming out again. But yeah, EJ finally lets everyone know that he's directing, and it gets off to such an awkward start when he does this little kumbaya circle and starts singing Do You Want to Build a Snowman in a very high voice, but thankfully, Ricky's signature late entrances end that, because I don't know how much I could have listened to that, even though I love you, Matt Cornett, and I love EJ. Didn't need to hear more of that. Then it goes into the auditions, which we had this great mashup of some Frozen songs. Also, anyone else catch Gina actually looking over at Ricky during his audition? Yes, she seems to still be thinking about him.
I won't be alone.
Then EJ hits another hiccup when it's time for scene auditions and there's no script, but thankfully Maddox saves the day, suggesting that they do this dramatic reading of song lyrics, and we see Courtney really connect to the lyrics of Let It Go. Now, I know in interviews, Dara Renee has said that Courtney really deals with anxiety this season, and we're going to see that, and I think she's gonna end up being a good Elsa if that's the role she gets. Then we have another late entrance to these auditions. Jet walks in, crashing them because he's been told that he either has to sign up for swimming or he has to be part of the musical. Well, he comes in and slays his rendition of For the First Time in Forever. Like, once that kid opened his mouth, I got chills, Ricky got chills, everyone starts cheering, but Jet just turns and storms out. Now, Ricky though, he's proud. He thinks he made an impact, I bet, on this kid, and he says that Jet's like a mini him. But we also have to sit and wonder, what's up with all the glances and reaction shots from Jet and Maddox these two episodes? When one's on screen, there's usually a shot of the other one glancing or scowling or like saying something sarcastic to the other, so there has to be some kind of history here, right? What is that mystery? Now, after auditions are over, Gina reminds EJ he did a great job and Miss Jens aren't built in a day, which is true, but then does something interesting. Gina kind of puts it out there that maybe they should take a break or play it cool so he can focus on directing. She kind of gives him an out, being like, I know you're gonna be super busy and whatever, and you gotta wonder why she's doing that. That's kind of interesting. But EJ's like, no, the only thing that I've been sure of this whole summer is you, Gina, so there's no breaking up, but they do agree to keep this professional distance at rehearsals. I'm curious though, if Gina was so sure about this relationship, why would she even say that in the first place? It should have just been like, hey, I know that you're the director now, so during rehearsals, maybe we should keep a professional distance to not let others get the wrong idea. That's all she needed to say. She didn't need to bring up the playing it cool and taking a break type of thing. There's some cute EJ and Ricky moments. I mean, we had that line from Ricky here, which is interesting.
We'll get to play the male leads together again, huh? Those guys. There's two of them. They're friends, enemies, lovers.
And then we see Ricky and EJ have a pillow fight, so I love that they're friends, and I don't want to see a girl come in between them either. Ugh, this loveness of teenagers, it's confusing. So towards the end of the episode, we have the girls discussing Maddox, who they kind of think is a lot, and Gina kind of stands up for Maddox, just being like, she just wants everybody to have fun and partake in her camp rituals and all this, and we then see that Maddox is kind of creepily in the woods setting up some kind of ritual, so like, what is she really up to? She is a mysterious character, but I like her. Then the episode ends with Carlos trying to find this cast list early for Frozen and breaking into the office where we see him change the cast list, but of course the episode ends before we find out who was cast and who he changes it to, but of course, Carlos thinks that this Disney Plus thing's his big break, so I'm sure he's trying to cast himself as Hans or Kristoff or something. But yeah, that's basically what went down this episode. Not too much drama, I guess, unless you count the glances, but we have these seeds of jealousy being planted. We have Ricky and Gina still being somewhat awkward towards each other, but trying to start over, but with those glances, and then with the Val and EJ thing that Gina's kind of made up in her head that maybe there's history there, she's kind of reading too much into that, that there's gonna be some tension here. Now, I am excited to hear more Camp Rock songs. They have teased that that's coming. We know It's On's coming, but Matt Cornett told me in an interview that his favorite song, one of them, is a cover that he and Sophia Wiley performed, so it's going to be an EJ and Gina duet. It's a cover. Has to be either from High School Musical or Camp Rock or Frozen. But I don't think EJ is going to be in the musical since he's directing, so what could that duet be? I'm still voting for Wouldn't Change a Thing because I just feel like that song fits so well into this season, and if they don't use it, it's going to be a really missed opportunity. But yes, so far, this season I think is fun. I think it's a lot lighter in ways because they're at camp, they're having fun, we have all this stuff going on. It's focused on a bunch of different people, and I like that. And I do like Gina and EJ together, but also I like Ricky and Gina together, but I do think Ricky needs to take a break from relationships. He just got out of one with Lily. Like, this boy needs to just work on himself. But what can we expect in the next episode? I haven't seen the teaser trailer yet, but I do know what happens in the next episode, and I can tell you, you're gonna find out who gets what role next episode, and you'll find out what's going on with Jet and Maddox. One thing I don't know about, and that I'm curious about, is how they're gonna wrap up Nini's storyline. But yeah, that's it for this week's recap. If you want, don't forget to check out my interviews with the cast. I got a bunch of them. You can find links down in the description below. But I gotta know, what do you think of this episode? What's been your favorite song so far? Is there a song that you're hoping that they sing from either High School Musical franchise, Frozen, or Camp Rock? Which couple are you shipping the most? Let me know all your thoughts and theories down below. And after that, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and check out more of my videos because I got a lot of things on this channel and I'll be here talking about High School Musical every week. As always, my name's Lisa, and thanks for listening to me ramble. I'll see you next time.